Hello everybody, this is John, W5CYF, and welcome to the garden of the Ham Shack, where I've got the antenna, the Hustler 4-band Trap Vertical, which has really worked out to be a great antenna. You might recall seeing a video recently where I added the 17 meter band to it. Today I'm going to make a bracket, a tilt over bracket. I'm going to need to do some adjustment on this antenna since I added the 17 meter band. It's a little out of resonance, nothing that the tuner can't take care of, but I would rather get it just a little bit closer to resonance, and in order to do that, I'm going to need to take the antenna up and down a little bit. Now, as you know, you can buy different antenna brackets, tilt bases that are out there. However, they run anywhere from around $70 really up to about as much as you want to pay for them. Well, at the end of the day, the tilt bracket is nothing more than a hinge. So I'm going to try to build one of those here at the shop, and I'm going to try to do it without any welding and materials that you'll find commonly at any hardware store or at any place where you could buy metal. Now, I'm going to be using the old school CAD program, which is simply some cereal boxes and a pair of scissors to lay everything out. So come along and join the journey as we build the tilt base that will be applicable to any other vertical antenna that you might have. So I hope you get some ideas for this video. Come on and join me in the shop as we continue. Now, as I said a while ago, we're going to be using my old school CAD program, which is nothing more than just a cereal box and a pair of scissors. Now, the material that I'm going to be using for this is just material that I picked up at the local metal supplier. This is 1/8 inch thick, 1 inch angle iron, and you're going to need 4 feet of this. The back plate, I am going to be using 1/8 or 125 thousandths by 4 inches. And this piece right here is 2 feet long. So that means I'm going to cut this in half. I'll have 2 1-foot pieces, and the angle iron will become the side braces. And again, I'm just making a hinge here. And let me say, if you think that you're following someone who knows what they're doing, just get rid of that thought right now. I'm only an amateur, and I am just doing this for my own personal use. I make no guarantee that this is even going to work at all. But on the other hand, it's nothing more than just a hinge. So I don't believe too much can go wrong. However, those perhaps are some famous last words. So what I'm doing right here is I am just making the side of the angle iron, and this is going to let me know where to put my screw holes at. So now that I've got this cut, essentially what's going to happen is one piece is going to be stationary and another piece will be bending down, and this becomes the hinge point right in here. Well, right here, I've got just a 1/4 inch bolt through there, and I'll be using stainless steel, but I'm going to be using 1/4 inch as my hinge point. And if I put it right there, this is going to make this end right here have plenty of clearance. Now, what I'll do is I'll come down here also and maybe cut a little bit off of this corner right here with the grinder, just make a slight angle on it, and that will be the hinge point. Okay, at this time I've got all the parts cut out, which, as I said before, are just the front plate and the back plate, and then I've got the 4 pieces of angle iron. Now I'm going to use 100% stainless steel here to put everything together, and I'm also going to be using this ox guard to go down here along each side when I put this on there, just to help with the corrosion factor or help prevent some of the corrosion and help increase the conductivity as it sits out in the weather. And once again, I'll be using all stainless steel fasteners throughout it. And then on the nuts, instead of using a lock washer, what I'm going to do, since there is wind and so forth out through there, I'm going to be using a little bit of blue Loctite only on the threads of the bolt. Now, down here where the hinge part is, I've got nylon lock nuts here, and this is going to be the part where it hinges on at the bottom, so I can just tighten this up so much and it'll still leave the ability to move back and forth as I turn it. You'll see how all that works when I put it together. So at this time, I'm just going to start assembling everything. Again, stainless steel, ox guard between the surfaces, and blue Loctite as a thread locker on the threads only. Okay, I've completed everything, and all I need to do now is just put the two halves together. And again, I'm going to use these nylon bolts here, or nylon nuts. One thing that I did find out that if you're building this, and you can use hand tools to build this, you do not need to use power tools or anything else. They do make it much easier. But one thing that you may want to consider if you're building yours, you probably aren't going to be able to see it, but right down in there, that nut should have been, or this bolt hole here, should have been a little bit over towards the center. I was able, because it hit the, if you look up here, you can see how it hits. It's too close. It should be over a little bit. Now, what I was able to do, I've got a milling machine, and I just milled out the section for the nut, and it fits down there really close. So you can see I've got the holes at the top, and I've got holes at the bottom. So these at the top will be how open and close it. It'll open and close that way. Well, I'll just go ahead and put these in here like this, and you'll be able to see it. Well, I'll tell you what, I'll put everything together, and I'll come back and show you how it goes. Well, I've got everything completed on it, and you can see how it folds open and closes back up. And that's essentially it. Now, the next thing I'll need to do is go out and take the antenna down, and then I'll mark. Okay, I've got this far here and got everything working. I've made a couple of changes to it. And one of them is more of just a safety thing. I don't know that you really would need it, but this will help while you're undoing your bolts at the top if you thought you needed something like that. It's just a pin that you pull out. And then, of course, the antenna can swing on down. And then you can put the pin back in it, slide it all the way across, and you can look in the top and put it through. And that'll hold it in place while you put the bolts in there. The other thing that I did, I probably, again, don't need it, but I just went ahead and did a ground strap between the front and the back. And I left long enough to where it can flex without any problem. Now, the next thing is I've gone out back and used my template here from the cereal box. And this is the template of the antenna base mount. So I need to go ahead and get it mounted on here, and then we'll be ready to go. So I'm gonna go ahead and lay this out, drill the holes, and the next time you see this, it hopefully will be mounted on the antenna. Okay, I've got everything hooked up, and a couple of things that I would change if I were doing it again. Now, I'm not gonna make another one, but if I were doing it again, I would use 1/4 inch back here. When I put the U-bolts in it from this side right here, you can see it deformed that back just a little bit, so I had to go in and realign these holes up here where the bolts go through. This is the safety switch that I put on it that goes through there. Well, I can't see with holding the camera and putting it back in, but that's the little safety latch on it. It does work really well. I'll show you in just a moment how to put it down. But overall, it worked out really well. Another thing that you may have noticed here at the bottom, right there in front of my finger, I had to dig out a hole for the antenna to swivel down on, or to hinge down on. The antenna's a little close to the ground. The pipe that I have is not tall enough. If I were to do it again, I'd get a longer pipe and put it probably 6 inches off the ground. But I'll go back and I'll put the antenna down for you and show how easy it is to use.
I'm going to go ahead and lower the antenna here. I've already undone all the bolts and everything, the two bolts that hold the sides in. I'm just going to pull the pin out and then grab it 2 or 3 feet above there so that it folds on down. Now, I've got a chair that's out there that'll catch it. I'm not going to lower it all the way. Then when you put it back up, you don't need to do anything. It's going to slip right in place. Then before you start doing your screws or your bolts or however you have it attached, just go ahead and put the safety bar in, and it's not going to go anywhere. At that time, you'll just go ahead and do your bolts. Well, I hope you got some good ideas out of that, so go ahead and get the tools out. As you saw, you could do this with a home shop. You could buy the metal locally and just use regular hand tools. You do not have to use the power tools that I used in my shop. A couple of things, once again, that I would change if I were doing it over again. I would use 1/4 inch plate for the back, so it would not be quite as susceptible to bending as this one was. However, I'm not gonna go back and change it. The tilt base works perfectly fine as it is. So I hope you got some good ideas out of this. This is John, W5CYF. We'll see you on the air, 73.